Welcome. Welcome in the name of Jesus, the Savior of the world. Just a quick note about our service tonight. I'm so happy to see so many people here tonight. For anyone who may need a nursery tonight, we do have nursery service available. If any kids get antsy at any point in the service, we're going to be having some wonderful music. I'm sure you've heard about the cantata, so I'm looking forward to that. Tonight, as we continue our Triduum 3 days worship, we will receive the word in song as the choir sings the cantata. I'd like to thank David Dunbar, who wrote the cantata. We have the composer here in the house tonight, as well as the choir for leading us in worship tonight and opening the scriptures to us in a new and special way this Good Friday. The cantata will expose us to many different voices throughout the story of the scriptures, and it will conclude with a sung amen. After the amen, please remain in your seats as long as you need for prayer and reflection, and please depart the sanctuary in silence. Tonight we marvel at the mystery of the cross, where Jesus was crucified, where the God of all creation, the creator of life, experienced the totality of death. We know that we can only call this Friday good in light of his resurrection, in the proclamation that the grave could not hold our God. Yet tonight, on this night, as we journey with Jesus to some very dark places, we remember that God personally knows our human pain and suffering, the pain of betrayal and loss, the pain of rejection, abuse, abandonment, and even the failure of government to deliver justice. God knows the pain and cruelty of violence and even death. On this night, we proclaim that God knows and God has not forgotten humanity in our suffering. And so we cry out for ourselves and for our neighbors to God, for those we know and those that we will never meet, because God's mercy is great enough for all. I invite you to remain seated in a posture of prayer and reverence for the bidding prayers tonight. The tradition of the bidding prayers has roots in the practice of praying with beads. So it's not bidding prayers, but beading prayers. We can think of it like that. The tradition of praying with beads, each bead offers an invitation, a guide. It invites us to pray for a particular concern. So tonight, as we pray, we will follow a similar guided meditation. I will invite us, let us pray for a particular concern, and we'll offer a space for silent prayer. And that silence will conclude with a prayer together, led by Pastor Joel. In the silence, listen to where the Spirit is drawing your attention. Let us pray, siblings in Christ, for the whole church throughout the world, for all who share our faith in Jesus.
Almighty and eternal God, you have shown your glory to all nations in Jesus Christ. By your Holy Spirit, guide the church and gather us throughout the world. Make us one in the fullness of faith. Overcome our divisions and unite us in the fellowship of love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray for all servants of the word and for all the people of God.
Almighty and eternal God, your Spirit guides the church and makes it holy. Strengthen and uphold our bishops, pastors, other ministers, and lay leaders. Help each of us in our various vocations to faithfully do the work to which you have called us. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray for those preparing for baptism and confirmation.
Almighty and eternal God, you continue to bless the church. Increase the faith and understanding of all who prepare for baptism and confirmation. Give them new birth as your children and keep them in the faith and communion of your holy church. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Let us pray for the Jewish people, the first to hear God's word.
Almighty and eternal God, you gave your promise to Abraham and your teaching to Moses. Fulfill your covenant promise to the people you called and elected as your own, and heal the wounds of anti-Semitism that persist in our world today. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Let us pray for all those who do not share our faith in Jesus Christ.
Almighty and eternal God, your love transcends every barrier we understand. Gather into your embrace all those who call out to you under many different names. Bring an end to interreligious strife and make us more faithful witnesses of the love made known to us in your Son, Jesus. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray for those who do not believe in God and for all who struggle with doubt.
Almighty and eternal God, you created humanity for communion with you, so that all may know you and find peace in you. Grant that all may know your love and grace in their lives. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray for God's good creation.
Almighty and eternal God, you are the creator of a magnificent universe. Hold all the world in the arms of your care and renew the face of the earth. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray for all who serve in public office.
Almighty and eternal God, you are the champion of the poor and oppressed. In your goodness, give wisdom to those in authority and overcome evil with good, that all people may enjoy justice, peace, freedom, and a just share in the goodness of your creation. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray for all who are in need this night.
Almighty and eternal God, you give strength to the weary and courage to those who have lost heart. Heal the sick, comfort the dying, give safety to travelers, free all who are deprived of liberty, and deliver your world from falsehood, hunger, and disease. Hear the prayers of all who call on you in any trouble, that they may have the joy of receiving your help in their need. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Finally, let us pray for those things which our Lord would have us ask, using the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial,
and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Behold the life-giving cross on which was hung the Savior of the whole world. O come, let us worship him. Behold the life-giving cross on which was hung the Savior of the whole world. O come, let us worship him. Behold the life-giving cross on which was hung the Savior of the whole world. O come, let us worship him.
that I release unto you, Barabbas, or this Jesus, King of the Jews.
Release unto us, Barabbas.
Say, crucify this one. Why, oh, why? What evil hath he done?
Release to us, Barabbas, and crucify Jesus the Jew. His blood be on us and on our children now and forever.
To love.